buddy all the way. Still in Malta. We are both in Malta, but he's a bit far in Dingley. So can you hear us, Andrew?
Hi everyone, my name is Andrew Zahmetsoller and I welcome you to this live video today with my friend Gordon Attard. Let's have
Awesome.
some fun.
Awesome. Let's have some fun. So before we get started, we're gonna wait so we can share this on some other platforms and maybe groups. You can do that. Okay, so welcome to you. Let us know in the comments below which country you're coming from. So maybe you can give you a quick shout out as well before we get started and
Sure.
share some thoughts. I mean, we wanted Andrew will agree definitely with me. We wanted to just share some thoughts and how maybe it can help somebody. If it can help this life, if it can help one or two people, we've done our job, right, Andrew?
It's enough for us. It's enough for us. If we reach one or two people, which we impact their lives and help them, feel better in these times of crisis, it's well worth it. It's well worth our time, and we're actually enjoying ourselves now, using staying in home productive,
Absolutely. So Andrew Zamitzoller, he's an online life coach. For those who are on my platform and are watching this, and this is an introduction. Maybe now is the time after this to introduce yourself, Andrew, to the people. But I know that he's helping a lot of people when it comes to the mental side, the mental health, if you will, on how you can cope within what's happening around the world. Again, we're not gonna focus on the negative things that you
No.
probably already know, right? But we're gonna share some tips, definitely. So Andrew, share with the people, so as they coming in on the live, a bit about your background story, and what do you do, and then we get into the discussion, brother.
I've been around these last 3 years with people with anxiety, people with depression, and with people who hope to achieve success and to, create the lives that they want and create mental toughness in their lives. And obviously, I've worked both physically in my local clinic here in Malta, and I've worked online with various people. My background is in clinical hypnotherapy and neuro-linguistic programming. It's helping people move forward instead of regressing backwards. I don't believe that there's nothing wrong with people. They just have negative thoughts which are holding them back, basically. And I wanted to do more of this stuff now because now more than ever, we might get knocked out in this negative loop of depression and, not having things to do. And I might share some good tips with you. Actually, I will share some good tips to you how you can create your mental toughness. Be more productive inside and go more within.
Awesome. Awesome. So for those who are watching this, if you have some questions before we start this live, and hopefully the next maybe 20, 30 minutes that we have for you, I know that you definitely make sure you watch and do what your government or what your country is saying when it comes to guidelines and procedures. Stay home, go out if you're permitted to buy groceries and things like that. So that's important. We should start also by thanking the doctors,
The
people in
doctor.
medicine, I mean pharmacists, nurses, firefighters, police, and everything that and volunteers as well, that they are working, putting 20 hours for
Yes.
helping during this pandemic time. Is it? Yeah.
Yeah, as Gordon said, we must obey our governments. We must also obey and respect and really appreciate the nurses, the doctors, the police, and soldiers, which are doing so much to keep us safe. This is a global thing, and each of us has the responsibility for this not to spread. So the governments, the World Health Organizations are giving us these tips in order for the pandemic not to spread, not to be all doom and gloom, because the world has passed through some serious times. For example, 9/11 is one of them. For example, we thought that the world was going to end there when they had the SARS, the other pandemics. But it's very important to know that there is always light in the tunnel. But it's always important that you take the massive action in order to win. You know what I mean? In order to win now is we need to stay at home and reduce human contact in order for this not to spread. We are both from Malta, and just up north, a lot of people are actually losing their lives in Italy. So The way it spread, it's maybe because, not to criticize the Italians or anything, but maybe they were a little bit irresponsible in the way that they didn't take it seriously. But now we know it's a serious thing. So since we know it's a serious thing now, it is time to work on ourselves. So let's start a little bit with some tips, strategies, some coaching right here, right now. When you have time now, if you're off work and if you are staying more at home, you have more time to work on yourself. For example, if you always had, for example, a fitness goal, I always like to bring examples with fitness, with the physical, because the physical is much easier to understand, Gordon, right, than the mental, because we can't see the mental, you know? If you had a fitness goal, for example, now it's time to work on it. For example, start working out more, or maybe start jogging. And you tell me, now I can't go to the gym. There's so many exercises you can do at home that it's ridiculous. You just go on YouTube, home workout, and you find hundreds and hundreds of all levels that you can do at home. So that is massive action number one in creating excellent fitness at home. You can also start by preparing your food. It's much easier now that you can have much more time to cook, for example, to eat healthy, to feel better, and to see the nourishment that good food gives you, instead of being on the go and going in Malta, for example, in the local pasticci shop, or, you know, eating a hamburger because you're a busy real estate agent or something, right? You're always on the go. Now you're not, you know, so now you have time to enjoy fruits, vegetables, and whatever you like. I mean, everything can be tasty. So that's in perspective. Or, for example, you can also try new things which you have never tried before. For example, like going deep within, like finding your life purpose, for example. Maybe you've been stuck in a 9-to-5 job for 10 years and you've hated your life. And actually, this coronavirus might be the blessing, which is going to kickstart your new career, you know?
Absolutely. Absolutely. That's already some great stuff, my man. So when it comes, I mean, you mentioned that time, everything that now is like, I think before we jumped on, you mentioned that you've never seen yourself and together with your family more close. So this is something that you should be grateful for. Okay, not with the situation, but again, what you focus on expands. This is something that I always talk about this. And since you value your time that you have in your hands, and you're surrounded with your family, maybe you have kids, those who are watching us, or the moms and dads. So when it comes to time, Andrew, what is something that when it comes with time that they have on their hands? What are some things, apart from you mentioned that they can cook like healthy, start eating healthy, start developing those different habits, that because of a lot of work, because of a lot of things going on in their life, this stalled everything. And now they have time to reprogram themselves.
Yes, yes. Exactly.
So what are some other things that in your opinion and your thoughts can do to have their time be useful for what's coming next, right?
So in the Western world, we're coming from a culture that everyone is busy being busy. Right. Like I've once read a book about the Tao. The Tao is a philosophy and a religion in ancient China, that they just go with the flow and live in the present moment. And in the Western world, unfortunately, we haven't been living in the present moment. We have been living in the past, and we've been living in the future, you know?
Right.
So everyone, now we've broken the cycle of being busy for the sake of being busy. Now it's time to be more present and be more in the now, you know? Be more in the now. For example, appreciating, like you said, we've mentioned family before the show, appreciating that you have a loving family, enjoy conversations, you know. If it's safe and if you're not on restricted lockdown, you can go on walks in places where there's no public, you know, not go in very public areas. And also, you can also take online courses, for example, to grow yourself, to grow your skills. You can also find the option of maybe working online if that's your cup of tea, you know? And you can also not only learn something new or read something new, you could also start a new hobby. Like, for example, if you always wanted to paint and you have no time to paint, now is your time to paint. If you always wanted to cook, now is your time to cook. So isn't it lovely that now everyone is not busy from being busy? But the problem that I'm going to find now in times of crisis, and people like me need to aware these people, that most of us are operating on what is called a monkey mind. The Buddhists call it a monkey right. mind. A monkey mind is when the mind does not settle, when the mind wants this and wants that and everything. And in reality, now that we have all this time on our hands, most people don't know what they're going to do with it. That's these are some things that they can do. And two, they're like you know, I've seen a status on Facebook said, you're trying not to kill us with lockdown, but you're going to kill us with a breakdown. You know, like,
I didn't see that.
Yeah, I've seen a status of a local guy, and he said, you know, the coronavirus is not going to kill us because now we're in a lockdown, but we're going to die out of a breakdown. So that's really funny.
It is. Yeah, so yeah, I just wanted to jump in real quick. I know that we've got people on Instagram. Shout out to those who are watching on Instagram. What's up, guys?
Hey,
those who are on Facebook, watching us on Facebook. If you have any questions while we're discussing this, fear of uncertainty in this adversity moment, okay? I believe that a lot of people, like Andrew mentioned, will come up with ideas. This is something that obviously it's hitting every single corner, four corners of the world.
Everyone.
Big ideas. There's people who are working on concepts, working on projects, developing new businesses because of the adversity coming out of this. A lot of other people, I mean the masses, are waiting for what the government's going to give them or waiting for what's going to happen next while they are like handcuffed or hand crossed. And they are not doing anything. Like you said, invest in yourself. Something that I always, when I do lives and when I do podcasts, invest in yourself. Something that you can go on places like Skillshare and learn a different skill that you can do digitally, you can do online, okay? There's so many things. I mean, I can keep going for hours and hours and hours on this subject, right?
There's thousands of books, which most of them might be rubbish, but then you'll find a sentence which can change your life. You know, there could be one book which can actually change your career. You know, I've read books which have really elevated my private practice and have elevated the way I work with people, for example. So if you invest in yourself is the greatest currency. You are valuable. And if you create more value, if you are able to give more value in the market, that is what's going to save you. Because unfortunately, due to this epidemic, like what we're seeing right now, there might be a little bit of an economic crash. So now it is the time that you invest in yourself, invest in your dreams, and say yes to your life. Because by saying yes to your life, you are not a victim anymore. You are not dependent on your governments, but you are dependent on yourself. And you owe it to yourself, you owe it to your family, and you owe it to your society to grow yourself to the maximum. Okay? You owe it to yourself to grow yourself to the maximum. And maximum doesn't mean you become the next, you know, America's Next Top Model or becoming, I don't know, the next pop star or the next Justin Bieber or Kim Kardashian. If that's your cup of tea, do it. But the thing is, you have to be the best you. If you have a takeaway, become the best in serving people in a takeaway. If you are a housewife, become the best housewife. If you're a therapist, become the best therapist you are. If you're a digital entrepreneur, become the best digital entrepreneur and network marketer there is. Invest in yourself. See what you can do differently than 99%. Because the 1% which control the world, they're thinking differently. Their psychology is differently. Everything is different. There's a bunch of secrets and stuff like that maybe that they keep on there. But we still can learn. And by learn, we can elevate ourselves and become the greatest versions of ourselves, you know?
Super, yeah. I agree with you. And in fact, when it comes to thinking, you just mentioned the word thinking. And when it comes to secrets, I mean, nowadays, we're so connected when it comes to how you use the things that it's available for us. When you go, like, I call it YouTube University. I don't know if you agree with me. I mean, I've learned so many things when it comes to skills and sayings and things from YouTube University. I mean, one can go and search whatever it is that they want to do with coming out from this. Maybe like you said, yeah. maybe they want to become singers. Maybe they want to come to learn how to play guitar or start an online business. You can go right now, after this, go on YouTube, and there's somebody teaching you how to start, what do you need, what tools you need, and within 30 days, you have, or even less, you have your business running.
I'm cool, learning. Man. Yeah, true. I'm learning Kung Fu, you know.
Now, there you go.
That's I can relate to. We are living in the best time in the world, in the information world, where this thing couldn't have happened. Imagine if this happened in the 90s. What are you going to do in the 90s, you know? Okay, I've mentioned books because I'm very old school and journaling, stuff like that. I still use that with my clients and myself and writing. You're seeing me with a pencil now. I'm still old school, but we're living in the best times ever. We have an abundance of free resources, you know, free resources from professionals. For example, me and Gordon, we're doing this because we have fun and we like to connect with you guys and stuff like that. But we are both professionals in what we do. So there might be a sentence while you are watching us right now that it might affect your life. It might inspire you, motivate you, or also, you know, give you value. And there's so much free resources. Even Udemy, for example, it's an online platform. It gives out free courses. And the courses there only cost about 16 euro. But then there's also, you have coupons where you can get a free course, you know? Or the YouTube University, like Gordon said. In YouTube, there's an abundance of things. And there's also libraries, free libraries, Livrobox recording of audiobooks for free. You don't need Audible subscription either, you know? You have to start with what you have and do the best you can with what you have. And knowledge grows, believe me. Knowledge grows. I mean, I've spoken to classes of doctors in the UK. I've also been on multiple television shows speaking to psychiatrists, blah, blah. And most, I've done the courses. I went to university, but most things that I have learned was online, you know? So this is the reality, guys. I mean, we're kind of spilling the beans. If you want to learn, online is the best. And if Gordon wants to add something, I'll let him speak because I'll go forever. And we'll touch on the fear of uncertainty, the psychology of fear. All right.
yeah, no problem. And just this is why I love these slides, because we can just discuss and jump on and things like that. So for those who are watching this, thanks, first of all. We're doing this for the very first time. I mean, I got to know Andrew Zamit Soler not so long. I mean, we connected through some other friends.
Yes.
And we kept in touch when it comes to Facebook. I mean, we chit-chat sometimes as well. And we're doing this for the very first time. So thumbs up if you hit the like button, share this around. And if you have a question that you can ask us, leave it in the comments below. And that will be something that we'll see if we have anyone and we'll definitely take care of that question. The other thing, Andrew, that we talked, let's transition now. We shared with those who are watching, we shared what they can do with time now that they have. What other options? You know, you need to try to reinvent yourself, reinvent the wheel. For some people, like, this is the reality. Some businesses are not going to make it, right? That's what's happened. Unfortunately, some businesses are not going to make it. Some others are going to barely make it. Some people who are working, they don't know coming out of this if they're going to have a job in the next 6 to 12 months. That's sad reality. But like Andrew said, what is that you're doing right now? I mean, what you can't control, you can't control. This is a quote. Like, I was on a call with 500 people, and this stood out from me. What you can't control, you can't control. Like, can you stop this? No. But can you control your time studying something, learn skill, et cetera, what we mentioned? So my transition is this. Why people fear? Why people are so afraid, okay, of every single minute, not just hour now, every single minute, wanting like that hunger to get those updates, and they are doubting themselves, doubting that, that is increasing inside of them, Andrew.
That's true. This is basic human nature, okay? In psychology, the one predominant fear, apart from the public speaking one, which is quite a new, it's the fear of uncertainty. Because human beings, as a species, want certainty. They want to know that they are loved. They want to know that they are safe. They want to know that they are secure, because it's hardwired in our psychology. Because if you're not safe, you know, in the past, a tiger might kill you, you know. And in the same, like now, if you are not strong economically, because you're still operating on what we call the monkey mind, we're not offending anyone, but you're still on the survival thing, you know, on the survival mode. You haven't opened up your perspective to reality, to different realities in all sense. You have this fear of uncertainty, which these coronaviruses, for example, I've mentioned September 11th, we've thought that we would not go through it, and the 2008 crash, and it passed, and economic prosperity came after 2008, which we were right now. So the reality is, this fear is irrational fear. This fear is not true. You cannot control it. The only way you can control to in every situation, my friend, not only the coronavirus, even if it's a breakup, even if it's depression, even if it's anxiety, it's how you react to it. It's how you react to the situation, which is either going to make you or break you. If you react in a way, like we have been speaking before, of growing yourself, of doing something productive, or just living in a present moment and living blissfully happy now, because why do we want more economic growth? Why do we want better careers? Why do we want to be famous? Why do we want? Because we think in our minds that it is going to make us feel good. So this is an opportunity, and I invite you now to feel good now. Because internally, you can make yourself feel good. Believe it or not, you can. You might think I'm superficial, because I will tell you just to close your eyes and remember a time when you felt really good, and make that picture bigger, bolder, stronger. Feel what you feel, see what you see, you know, and you are just creating the feel-good factor within you, and you are reliving a happy, good memory. You will start feeling good. You can try that, or we can do another live video or something, doing an entire anchoring exercise, which we call it in NLP. And the thing is, feel good now, live in the present moment, because you cannot control the future. You cannot control the past, because the past is gone. You can create your future with necessary action, but you cannot have full control. So the best thing in this corona epidemic is we surrender. And surrendering means letting go of the burden, because the only thing you could do right now is to take the necessary precautions for you and your family. Worrying is not going to eliminate corona. Worrying is not a corona vaccine. Worrying and stress will actually make you sick with something else. Or actually, you might manifest coronavirus upon yourself, since it's spreading. Because you're constantly stressing, constantly thinking about this negative thing that might happen to you. And guess what? It might happen. It might actually happen. So shift your mind, shift your mindset, get mentally tough, believe in yourself, focus on the mind, go within and say to yourself, this time shall pass. And guess what? Each and every one of us, which we are going to make it through this coronavirus, we are the generation which survived this massive epidemic, this massive attack on humanity. And if after this, I mean, everyone has common sense, there's going to be a little bit of economic hardships, we can. Everything is the law of rhythm. Sometimes you're up, sometimes you're down. We can overcome. For example, you can also be smart in this time. That's how the 1% get rich. For example, if you have some money saved up now, you can either invest in something, for example, silver, gold, etc. Don't go on me, because I'm not a trader. I'm just a therapist and coach. But for example, the thing that I have done is, when I'm seeing the British pound going down, but I know the British economy will get much stronger than the European one, you can just convert euros with a simple application we have to the British pound, which you will take it now almost equally. Then when it's back, for example, 1 euro is to 75 cents, you change it again and you make 1,000 euro profit. So these recessions, sometimes there's some conspiracy theorists who say that these recessions are purposely purposefully made for the 1% to accumulate more wealth, more property, on a cheaper thing, on a cheaper price. So you can also act smart and be part of that 1%. Not take advice from me, research yourself, because I can give you amazing advice on psychology, how to feel good, how to be successful, but financial advice, don't stay on me. But that's just some ideas that I know for a fact, since I'm in this personal development and self-help game, that this is how it works, you know? You can read Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki, for example. If you are a personal development crowd, that is something which he knows and says that in economic crisis is the time when you can get rich. Warren Buffett doesn't like these times, which we were living in, because everyone was getting rich, even ordinary, you know, schmucks, and he couldn't afford, you know, especially in our country, for example, in Malta, property has ballooned. You know, no one can afford anything. You know, even the rich people can barely afford to buy in cash because it was so high. Right. Now, these people who have cash money are going to take advantage of the situation, and they will buy bucket loads of properties. And, you know, that's how the world.
After
money is energy. Don't worry. Money is energy.
Yeah. So, like you said, you know, I think it was some, I don't know exactly who said it, but after recession, there's expansion. So it is a good time when it comes to investing. Definitely, this is a good time. Like you mentioned the property here. I think my brother shared with me something that properties are being priced. I mean, the prices are getting lower. So there's opportunity when it comes to investing. We're not going to talk about what you can invest in again, but just to share with you some ideas and tips. It is a good time if you're someone who has that entrepreneur spirit. You can start your own business. That's number one thing, because then with the money that you're making, you can invest it. We're not saying, hey, put your savings in one thing and things like that. We're against that, obviously. Great book that Andrew shared, Rich Dad Poor Dad, definitely changed my mind when it comes to how money works. Definitely go and read it. You can find it and things like that. What's that?
Money is a monopoly game.
Yeah.
And the thing is, when we come back to fear, is, for example, if you have fear of money, if you have that lack mentality, obviously money is going to fly away from you. Because if you hold and not expand, you're going to either stay the same or your money is going to decrease. So have no fear in reality, because the more fearful you are, the less likely you're going to go for your dreams, the less likely you are to make more money. Because entrepreneurs, I've worked with a lot of entrepreneurs and also CEOs, most of them are fearless, you know? Most of them just lose. Sometimes they lose too much, you know? So, and then, you know, but then they have that one victory and everything changes. But in reality, like we were saying, is when I was saying money is energy. For example, I pay Gordon to say thank you for his service, and he gives me his service as an energy back. For example, I give my money to a supermarket and they give me products as a thank you. If you look at money as this godlike thing, you're going to suffer both mentally, spiritually, and financially, ironically. And because do not put so much weight on this piece of paper, on this asset, on this whatever it is. Things change fast. You might get an opportunity that you have never dreamed of. And that's how, you know, the work I do is helping people reprogram their unconscious, subconscious mind to remove negative behaviors that they might pass. For example, if you are feeling down right now and you are feeling that you are not good enough at the moment, start by writing everywhere all around your house that I am enough. You know, start to accept yourself that you are enough. You know, start reprogramming your mind to be more happy, healthy. There's no need to study hours and hours and working on yourself, like we said. All it takes is that one skill which you will be amazing in and giving value to the world. That's which going to make you financially free. And do not watch constant news, etc., etc. Now that the country is gone. blah blah blah, and we have to send foreigners out. And because if you reprogram your mind in that negative mindset, you are going to go with the flow. And if you go with the flow, you're going down the toilet, my friend, with all of your countrymen and women. I'm not saying that the news is bad, but that is how they work. They sensationalize, they make things newsworthy. And unfortunately, me having worked in the past in criminal justice, people like doom and gloom, you know? People like these police shows, and people like these CSI and blah, blah, blah. And in reality, I've done that. I was a criminal analyst and it's not that exciting as you think. You know what I mean? Criminal justice is the most negative thing I've seen in my life. And people, it's newsworthy, you know? It's doom and gloom. You know what I mean? Like police stuff and economic crashes, stuff like that, they get more coverage than personal development. You know, because it's newsworthy, like it invokes fear, and that's what they want. That's what the media wants, creating emotion within you.
I've got a question, Andrew. Sorry to cut you off. I've got a question here on Instagram, and this person said, how can I get into like circle of influence people, because I'm surrounded with negative people. So what can I do to get out of that negative bubble, negative surroundings, to move forward in life? This is a great question, right?
An amazing question.
I mean, you'll go after sharing some things. I mean, one thing that you should do is you need to unsubscribe yourself. It could be a family member. It could be a friend, best friend. Some people get attached to them because they've been with them. They know them for a very long time. You've got to stop doing that. You've got to unsubscribe from negativity. I did that a few years ago. Okay. I love my friends. I love my friends who I was brought up, but I had to unsubscribe from that negativity in order to get something different. You've got to do something different. And it starts with unsubscribing from that surroundings. Then that's the first part. Second part is you need to find people that have a heartbeat that is beating fast, you know, like us, you know, like find these people, and you can go and network, you can go to events and find
them.
They're everywhere. You go and find them and surround them yourself around them. Don't let them go, because if you are in a room, this is something that it's funny, but if I want to call like this, or if I'm in a room, I want to be in a position that I'm on a student mode, so I can learn all the time, not just being someone who's sharing stuff. Yeah, number one. Second thing is, in that room, I'm the less expert, or I'm the less sort of knowledge-wise. So I'm in a room with someone who's outthinks me, someone who's better than me. This is how you grow. This is how you start going into the next level in your life. And that's my take on this. What about you, Andrew?
Obviously you are the top five people you hang out with in reality, but I also understand you, and it might be difficult for you due to various problems, maybe location and anxiety issues or whatever, that you can also get virtual mentors. For example, if you see someone who inspires you, you can watch them more on YouTube, read more of their books, relax your vision and see how they speak, act, talk. Early on in my career, I am one of the first hypnotists in the country. So I had no one and still have no one to network with, because I am one of the pioneers in this field, because then there was someone who was from abroad. There is a lot now popping up, but they can't network with me because they're from different backgrounds, you know? We don't have networking stuff. What I did is I grabbed people which I liked, for example, Dr. Richard Bandler, Tony Robbins, and all these people who I admire, and Marissa Peer. And I've watched and read and acted as if they are my friends. And whenever I see, for example, Marissa Peer on YouTube, I like cry out of gratitude. because, like, thank you, Marissa, for inspiring me.
Yeah.
Thank you, giving life. Like, now I've revisited all my Bandler tapes, which I had, and I'm like, wow, just watching a video of this guy makes me more positive and makes me work even better. And since I've been watching these videos, which inspired me 3 years ago in the early of my career, I've been getting more results than ever, because never get comfortable. Don't think because you are a professional and you have this much letters behind your name, you know, trust me, you are nothing, because I have this much letters, but I am no one. I still learn. Last time I went to the University of Malta to meet some psychology students, and they taught me so much. And they were like, we thought, in their eyes, I felt that I didn't live to the hype, because they thought I was going to take over. And then they see me like I'm here now, all timid and being honest, etc. And that's it. This is who I am. I'm always willing to learn, you know. So grab these virtual mentors or coaches. If you can afford, you can hire a coach to help you to become more positive. You can also go into these chat groups. There's Facebook groups, for example, that like the things that you like. You know what I mean? And you make friends and network and FaceTime with these positive people. You can go, like Gordon said, hang out with people which are going to help you grow. Do not hang out with people who are going to, I say this respectively, who are going to take you backwards instead of forward. And because you're going forward, once you make it, you will be able to help the others. But listen, misery enjoys company, and failure enjoys company. So these people who are trying to hold you back and tell you, listen, don't do this, don't do that, and try to make fun of you and this and that. I had that a lot from the beginning, you know, like everyone else. But then they come with you, you know. It's funny then. Everyone wants to be your friend.
They watch you on TV or on the internet.
That's true. But the reality is that they might have a fear. They love you so much that they might have a fear of losing you. But if your heart says you want to go for it, if all you see for yourself is that thing, you can grab these tips that me and Gordon have given you, and they will work 100%, you know. If you want to become a writer, grab all the books of your favorite writer and see and analyze how she or he writes, you know. Inspire yourself with their stories. Like, for example, using your imagination of performing, using your imagination. The best magicians, I've hung out with a lot of magicians back in the UK, and even locally I've seen some magicians, but obviously here is a little bit more limited than London. What they do is, to create a card trick, they visualize it over and over and over again inside their heads. Then their motor skills, their hand skills, will go in par with their subconscious mind. You know what I mean? It's like they visualize themselves. They see themselves as if they already won. Michael Jordan did it, you know? All these great people do it. They go into flow state. For example, me, I'm no great person. I'm not an MJ. But sometimes I just put on piano music, grab my hypnosis scripts, etc., and I just scribble, and my vision goes blurry, and I start, you know, I'm in the flow state. I start reading and imagining myself doing this and that, and, you know, helping people, etc. So that is a flow state. You need to get in that flow state. And an army of three is better than an army of 100. If you choose quality over quantity, it's better to have one friend which is empowering you than a lot of friends who are going to drag you down. So I hope that answers your question, my friend.
That's awesome. Great tips right there. In fact, a great book that I always like to share on this live is called The Compound Effect by Darren Hardy. Go check it out, The Compound Effect. and it involves, and he talks about who you need to surround yourself with, and that creates the compound effect, something that you're not going to see your efforts that you're putting in now. You're not going to see it tomorrow, but you're going to see it on the long run. So okay. We're going to come up and wrap up this awesome call. Guys, let us know if you're still on and watching this. Comment below. What are your thoughts? Share with us your thoughts. What you got out of this? Tag someone that you see that this will help them out in their life. Would love to connect with you also. If you have any more questions, you can reach out to both Andrew and I privately. But before I let them go, where they can maybe last message. Let's do this. Last message from you, Andrew, and then tell us where they can connect with you to see what projects you're working on, my friend.
Yes, you can connect with me on my Facebook page. It's Andrew Zamitsoler. We can link it below if you can. It's my personal page, but I use it more as well. I post a lot of motivational stuff, live videos, and you can catch up with what I do. And my last message is always, always invest in yourself, invest in your greatness, and love each other and respect each other. This might sound cliche or a little bit hippie, but in reality, if you give love, you get love. If you give prosperity, you get prosperity. So always keep in mind, you get what you give. So do not be fearful, because more fear will come your way. And it was an amazing talk with my friend Gordon and all of you who have watched us.
Yeah. Love it, man. Love it. We should do this pretty much in the next few months or few weeks. Let's see how we can develop something together. So once again, thanks, Andrew Zamit. That was Andrew Zamitsoler. Soler on this live, online life coach, hypnosis. Go check him out, what he's working on, connect with him. He's doing some great things.
And I will love it.
He's also, if you're watching this from Malta, he's usually on TV, giving a lot of value on air as well. So having said that, that's all for this live. Thanks for watching. I appreciate you guys. Stay safe, stay strong, and stay inside. Those are the three stays, right? And we'll see you on the next episode, next Facebook Live.
Thanks for watching.
God bless. Have a great
day.
Take care.
Thank you. Thank you for the invite.
Okay. Boom.
We start. Hi, Irene. All right. Tajja bakjena tu.
Tajba ħafna.
Ħad pjaċerin kal-meġbin.
Ejwa, le, dikenet tajba.
Tajba.
Issa.
Tajni għom ħafna value, eh?
ħafna. Sada forsi, da.
Issa bat il-video u nixxerjaħ.
Fil-dakjat.
Ejwa.